स्टार्टिंग माय पेपर प्रेजेंटेशन. सो द टॉपिक ऑफ द पेपर इज एमआरआई इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स मेनिस्कल इंजरीज ऑफ नी एंड एनालिसिस ऑफ अ सीरीज ऑफ 64 स्टडीज वाज डन. आई डिड दिस पेपर अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ डॉक्टर पूर्णचंद्र लामघरे सर, डॉक्टर अमित खराज सर एंड डॉक्टर यशराज पाटिल सर. दिस स्टडी वॉज कंडक्टेड इन डॉक्टर डी आर पाटिल हॉस्पिटल पुणे. सो स्टार्टिंग विद द एम्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव टू स्टडी द रोल एंड टू प्रॉपरली कैरेक्टराइज द कॉम्प्लेक्स मेनिस्कल इंजरीज ऑफ नी. Next is the materials and methods. So MRI was performed in Siemens Magnetron 1.5 Tesla MRI system and Siemens Magnetron 3D Tesla machine as shown in the figure along with the knee coil. Next is the protocol that was used. So sequences were taken in proton density fracture, coronal, axial and sagittal planes. Sagittal T2 and coronal T1 sequences were taken for each patient as shown in the figure. An example, as per the patient's condition and requirements, suitable variations were made. So starting on with the menisci, they are basically semilunar fibrocartilages that are triangular in section, and they are present in between medial and lateral condyles of tibia and femur. They play a crucial role in stability and kinetics involved in the knee function. So how does an injury occur? As we already know that meniscal injuries are usually seen in a flexed knee, that is in 10 to 20 degree flexed knee, whenever there is twisting injury. So the types of injuries are shown in the figure. They are usually divided into complex and simple tears. So instead of the simple tears, we have horizontal, vertical, and oblique tears. With complex tears, we have bucket handle and complex tears. Associated complexities involved were loose bodies, intra and perimeniscal cysts, osteochondral defects, and cartilage thinning or loss. I'll be showing you some important cases that we included in our study. So this is a case of 30-year-old male patient who had a history of twisting knee injury. These are the sagittal and coronal sequences. As we can appreciate that there is injury to the medial meniscus, and dividing it into medial and the lateral meniscal fragments, the medial fragment is getting flipped and reaching the intercondylar notch. And in the sagittal plane, we can appreciate that it is oriented parallel to the intact posterior cruciate ligament, giving the characteristic double PCL sign that is diagnostic or in some cases important for investigating bucket handle tears. So bucket handle tears are seen, they are basically vertical tears or longitudinal tears with longitudinal extension along the course of meniscus that divide the meniscus into medial and lateral fragments as evident in this case. Next is a case of 21-year-old male patient who presented to us with after a history of fall 1 year back. And as we can appreciate that in the sagittal and the coronal PDFS MRI sequences that there is injury involving the medial meniscus, particularly the posterior horn. And this is a complex tear that is having two components, that is the horizontal and the vertical component. So complex tears usually do not have a specific appearance and can have different components, such as in this case. Next is the case of 28-year-old male patient who presented to us with a history of pain and swelling in the knee. In these images, we can appreciate that there is a complex tear involving the medial meniscus, particularly the anterior horn, and the body portion with slightly laterally flipped meniscal fragment. This is considered as an important complication with meniscal injuries. 37-year-old male patient, next case, who presented to us with history of pain and swelling in the knee, that pain was progressively increased just prior to the MRI. So here in the MRI, we can appreciate that there is involvement of anterior horn, the body, and the posterior horn of the medial meniscus, and there is a horizontal tear. So as we already know that horizontal, oblique, and in complex tears, they usually have poor prognosis even after surgery. Small tears are usually treated conservatively. Large tears usually require partial meniscectomy, and treatment is usually required in young patients as they have a chance of developing arthritis at the weight-bearing portion of tibiofemoral joint. Vertical tears, as we already know, that they extend along the course of meniscus. So they have excellent chance of healing, and they are excellent candidates for surgery in case if it is required. Next are the complexities. So this is a case of 22-year-old female with an old history of injury while playing. So in axial and the sagittal sequences, we can appreciate a large cystic lesion that is evident, appearing hyperintense on PDFS sequences. And this is present at the portion of the anterior horn and a slight at the portion of the lateral meniscus, anterior horn, the lateral, and the anterior portion of the body of the lateral meniscus. And this cystic lesion is showing few septae. So this is a complex cyst. Next is a case of a 48-year-old male patient who presented to us with a history of pain and swelling in the knee since 6 months. As it is clear, as you can clearly see that the meniscus, medial meniscus is involved, and there is a significant loss of the cartilage. Along with that, few small subchondral cysts and merodema is evident. So this is a case of chondromalacia at the weight-bearing portion of the medial condyles of tibia and femur. Next is a similar case. So this is a 52-year-old male patient who had a history of pain and diffuse swelling in the knee since 1 year. Subchondral cysts are evident at the along with merodema and significant loss of the adjacent cartilage. There is slight extrusion of the medial meniscus with marked degeneration as well as injury of the medial meniscus. And the subchondral cysts and merodema, they are seen at the medial condyle of the tibia. Some important statistics. So the type of meniscus involved. So in majority, out of the 64 studies, in 21 cases, both lateral and medial meniscus was involved. Isolated medial meniscal injuries even within 38 cases. Next are the pie charts that depict the portion of the meniscus involved. So in cases of medial meniscus, in majority cases, the posterior horn and the body were involved. And similarly, in lateral meniscus, posterior and body were more commonly involved as compared to the anterior horn and the root injuries. Next is the complexities that we already saw. So in 19 cases, osteochondral loss, osteochondral defects along with cartilage thinning and loss was present. Next complexity was a loose body and then the cyst. Next is the type of tear. So in medial meniscus injuries, the most common tear was the complex tear seen in 36 cases. Then was the bucketendal tear. Similarly, in the lateral meniscus, the most common were the complex tears and second most common were the horizontal tears. In the next pie charts, I depict the same thing. At last, a discussion. So in this paper, we found that meniscal injuries were slightly more common in males and traumatic cases were more common than the degenerative ones. So the maximum number of patients that were found were in the age group of 31 to 40 years of age, as we already saw in the previous table. So majority of the tears that were found were the complex tears, and the second most common were the bucketendal tears. Other tears that were considered were the longitudinal, oblique, and the vertical tears. At last, the conclusion. So MRI plays a crucial role and it is considered an investigation of choice for diagnosis of meniscal injuries of the knee. A detailed evaluation by MRI can help us early diagnosis and treatment, especially in cases of unstable injuries of knee that require early and prompt treatment. MRI can also help in diagnosis of the lesions or injuries that can change the course of treatment, particularly in young patients having unstable knee injuries. Thank you.